the Margaret Thatcher Center for Freedom at the Heritage Foundation, a conservative think tank. Nile, thank you for being here. I wanted to address this. Earlier this week, President Trump told a reporter that he was discussing with Putin, his discussions with Putin were, quote, none of your business. You heard him tell Putin there, don't meddle in a playful way. Does that signal that the president isn't taking this issue seriously?
Well, I think it's a very serious issue, the issue of Russian interference in elections, not only in the United States, but also across Europe and across the world. And the message has to be sent very loud and clear to Moscow that this is completely unacceptable. And I do think the Trump administration has taken this issue very seriously. I think there has been a concerted effort to ensure that there is no further Russian attempt to interfere in U.S. elections. And I think also governments across Europe are doing the same thing, really. And so this is an extremely serious issue. And I think it's important to bear in mind that Russia is not a potential friend or partner or ally of the United States. Russia is an adversary. It is a hostile regime whose principles are fundamentally different to those of the United States and U.S. allies. And so in every single meeting with Vladimir Putin, it has to be underscored that the Russians need to change their behavior. The Russians need to end their aggression against the free world and stop their interference as well in elections across the West. And we have to reiterate that message over and over again to Mr. Putin and his dictatorial regime.
We know that the president has faced backlash at home for his relationship with Putin. How are America's allies viewing these interactions? And do you think that they could hurt his talks with other world leaders at the G20 summit?
Well, I think it's important to bear in mind that actually U.S. policy towards Russia right now is very tough, it's very robust. And if you look, for example, at the increase in U.S. forces on the ground in Europe, the strengthening of sanctions that are in place, the supply of defensive weapons to Ukraine, on every single front, the U.S. approach towards Russia is very, very tough. It's important, I think, that the president reflects the actual policies that are in place and sends a very clear message to President Trump on many, many fronts that his behavior is unacceptable. I do think there is an understanding across Europe and across the NATO alliance that the United States is adopting a very robust stance towards Russia, and that stance must be continued. It's imperative that all NATO allies increase their defense spending and step up to the plate and increasingly shoulder a big part of the burden as well in terms of confronting the Russian military threat. So I think it's significant that you have seen NATO spending increase over the last 2.5 years. You have seen, I think, a tougher stance adopted by NATO towards Russia. We need to see a continuation of that, and U.S. leadership is vitally important. And there is real leadership, I think, with regard to standing up to Russia at this time. But I do think it's imperative that President Trump reinforce this message at every opportunity when he does encounter Putin at these summits, actually, such as the G20.
Let's turn now to the Middle East in referring to it with the G20 summit here. President Trump said there is no rush to ease tensions with Iran. How are America's allies responding to the president's message on Iran?
Well, again, U.S. leadership is vitally important in confronting the Iranian threat. And I think that the president will be underscoring at the G20 the importance of all of America's allies working together with the United States in ensuring that the threat from Iran is significantly reduced. And the U.S. focus is on ensuring that Iran does not have the capability to develop a nuclear weapons program. It does not have the capability to threaten the entire Middle East and ends its support for terrorism and overseas interventions in Yemen, Syria, Iraq, for example. And I think that it is important that the entire free world works together with the United States. Unfortunately, I think in Europe at this time, especially with France, Germany, the European Union as a whole, there is an appeasement mindset that is in place towards Iran. I think the European countries are placing business interests ahead of national security. But there is a divide in Europe on this particular issue. I think you could see a significant change in British policy, for example, once Theresa May steps down, and you could see the possibility of Britain withdrawing from the JCPOA Iran nuclear deal. There's also, I think, unhappiness in parts of Eastern and Central Europe with the EU approach towards Iran. So Europe is not united on this issue, but I have to say that it's very disappointing to see Germany and France in particular trying to sidestep US sanctions against Iran. We need to see all US allies working together and confronting the Iranian threat.
I think a lot of people would agree with you on that point. The president is also meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping tonight. He says to expect productive talks. That's a quote from him, but trade discussions broke down back in May. What do both sides need to do in this meeting to move towards ending this trade war?
Well, we do need to see both sides avoiding a wholesale trade war, and I do think that you'll see some momentum in that direction, actually, at the G20. I think that it's in the interest of both Washington and Beijing to back off from large-scale tariffs that ultimately are going to hurt the US and Chinese economies. And I think tariffs are a tariff on American workers, consumers, and businesses. And I think that, you know, US consumers do not need to have additional taxes to pay as a result of tariffs. And so I think that both sides will want to avoid the kind of trade war that would have very damaging implications for the global economy and also for the stock market here in the United States as well. I think that President Trump is acutely aware of that. But at the same time, the United States needs to maintain the pressure, I think, on China to change some of its trading practices. And I think there will be more targeted approaches taken by the United States in terms of addressing what is seen as a significant national security threat as well coming from China. So, for example, Huawei is seen as a national security threat here in the United States. I expect that you're going to see the continuation of U.S. measures in place against Huawei and other Chinese high-tech companies that are seen as a national security problem for the U.S.
Now, Gardiner, thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Salt Lake City police say one person has been